Fox 5 Health News and plant-based diets and foods are growing in popularity, exploding really, but you do have to be mindful of making sure that you're getting enough of an important nutrient linked to brain and muscle health.
All right, joining us now, nutritionist Shari Bookfar. We're talking about choline, which is very important nutrient that you just have to make sure you're getting enough of if you do make the transition.
Yes, and no matter what type of plant-based or vegetarian or vegan type of diet, you want to make sure it's planned well, and if it is, then it's not a concern. So choline in particular, this area of research, what they looked at is that choline, which is very important for brain health and heart health and liver function, is found in eggs, beef, and milk primarily. Mm-hmm. So if you are following more of a plant-based diet, the concern is that perhaps you may not be getting enough. But the good news is if you're planning it properly, it's found in vegetables, in particular broccoli and Brussels sprouts, the cruciferous ones. It's found in quinoa. It's found in beans and legumes. So as long as you're including these foods in your diet and it's well planned, then you can make sure that you're getting enough. But but when you're following these plant-based meals, whether it's protein or choline or any other vitamins or minerals or macro and micronutrients, you want to make sure that you're getting enough.
Let's just make an important distinction for anybody who's not sure of this. When you say a plant-based diet, that can be either or both, vegan or vegetarian.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
So there's no definition for plant-based.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. A vegan diet and a vegetarian diet are a plant-based diet.
Right.
But somebody might say, I'd like to follow more of a plant-based diet, but may actually include some meat products. It's
right.
more of a kind of a philosophy, if you will, rather than a legal definition of it. But it's a form of, I feel like it's a little bit of a buzzword.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And also meats are, you know, with Beyond Meat and a lot of these other products are becoming, those meat products are becoming more plant-based also. So it depends what you're referring to when you say that word.
Most definitely got it.
Well, giving kids multiple vegetables to try at a meal could reduce the chances they'll be a picky eater. Basically, the more you introduce your kids to younger, the better chances you are of having them be more ambitious with what they eat.
Yes, but taking it one step further, what this study actually looked at was, it was actually a small study of about 32 families, and they broke into groups feeding children, their children aged 4 to 6, either a medley of vegetables, it was broccoli, zucchini, and peas, or just one vegetable, or none at all.
Mm-hmm.
At the beginning, there was no change, but after the 5 weeks, they found that the children that had the medley of vegetable, the choices, actually ate more vegetables. It wasn't a whole lot. It was about half a serving to a little over one serving, but the other two, there was no change at all. So it you know, it's interesting. As a parent, so many times we give that one vegetable on the plate, although when I was younger, we used to have that medley of vegetables with the corn and carrots and peas.
And all that.
Right.
Frozen bag of
yes. Perhaps, you know, our parents really knew something, that was the way to increase our vegetable intake, was to give a whole variety of vegetables.
As opposed to making it one thing maybe the kid hates,
exactly.
And then they just have a negative association.
And reintroducing it, too. So if you keep giving, let's just say you pick 3 vegetables and you keep giving that, then perhaps over the course
of five weeks, they would
eat more.
That makes sense. That is interesting.
Especially if you try it different ways.
That all checks out to me.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Nick, really high.